Can you get a sense of the breadth of Google Cloud Platform by looking at compute products in just a few minutes? Let's find out. Arguably, the hello world in cloud is to provision, start, and connect a virtual machine. Google Compute Engine enables you to create single VM instances from scratch by specifying a region, a machine type, an OS image, and other optional parameters. Note how a cost estimate is provided while you configure the VM. A few options that I really like to point out is the ability to add GPUs or TPUs, that is, Tensor Processing Units, to your instance, and the plethora of OS images that are supported, including numerous Linux distros and MS Windows, plus the support to use a custom image if you see fit. Once you click Create, give the system a little time to boot your instance, and then you'll be able to SSH into it right from a browser. You could also have created a new VM from a previously saved template or from one of the numerous ready-to-go solutions on the marketplace. Now, the marketing group would be upset if I didn't take a moment and list all the other advanced features of GCE, including fine-grade security access control, HTTPS connectivity, truly stunning live migration of running applications, preemptible VMs, and more. These machines are on the Google network, which means that they'll have minimal latency and great throughput for everything that requires accessing remote services. Now, one of the reasons that Compute Engine is so nice is that it gives you complete control, but with that control comes a great deal of management overhead. Thankfully, Google Cloud Platform has offerings in the other side of the spectrum, where you just focus on code, and we handle the rest. Of course, we're talking about Google Cloud Functions. The serverless flavor of a hello world has to be built on Cloud Functions. Here, we provide a simple snippet of code to listen to image file uploads into a storage bucket to create thumbnails for each one of them on the fly. To trigger this code to run, simply upload an image to your bucket, and the function will do the rest. Now, Cloud Functions support a lot of triggers, such as changes in a database, messages from PubSub, or even Compute Engine instances changing state. Cloud Functions can also be invoked using a standard HTTP request, meaning a user visits a URL and the function does the work. These functions can be deployed in any region from a single project, and they're authenticated with the rest of GCP's services, making integration with other products and APIs from the platform quite natural and easy. Now here's the best part. For Cloud Functions to work, you don't have to provision a cluster or deal with server configs. We do that for you. And since most of the work you do with Cloud Functions is temporal, it means you only pay for the code that you're running while it's running. No traffic, no cost. Now, one challenge we have with Cloud Functions is that while they're easy to use, they make large-scale app development a little trickier. So if you need something larger than Cloud Functions, but still want serverless benefits, you should check out App Engine, which has the same scale on demand, but a lot more configurations for developers, such as services, versioning, and traffic splitting. And of course, you can't talk about cloud in 2019 without talking about containers. The hello world in container land is to deploy a Docker image to an orchestrator. Since Google open sourced Kubernetes, we've gotten a lot of feedback about what works and the challenges involved with deploying containers. This led to the development of Google Kubernetes Engine, or GKE, a fully managed version of Kubernetes. You can deploy your containerized applications to GKE, which offers a production infrastructure guaranteeing uptime while providing rich dashboard metrics and automated operations, from autoscaling to node repairs to Kubernetes version upgrades. To deploy a containerized workload, simply describe the compute, memory, and storage resources your application containers require, and Kubernetes Engine will provision and manage the underlying cloud resources automatically. With GKE, you can also attach persistent storage. You can even run stateful workloads, such as databases. You can also make use of GPUs and TPUs. But best of all, your Kubernetes workloads are portable across all Kubernetes implementations, from your development environment to GKE to other cloud or on-premises installations. In summary, GCP supports all types of compute workloads. It will run existing Linux and Windows applications on Compute Engine, containerized workloads on Kubernetes Engine, and functions or apps on Cloud Functions and App Engine. Give us the artifact of your choice and will provide a fast and reliable underlying infrastructure. Consider taking free code labs linked in the description below to explore these products and look forward to upcoming videos on data, storage, machine learning, and more overviews. If you like this video, please like, subscribe, comment, and share. See you soon for another GCP Essentials video.